And there he put the man whom he had formed. Verse 9. And out of the ground, the Lord God made every tree grow that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life was also in the midst of the garden. And everybody go. And the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Okay? So how many of us have knowledge of evil? Raise your hands. How many of you, even in spite of that knowledge, you still commit evil things? And you know, you have knowledge of it, and it's not going to happen to me. And I know it says that, but I'm still going to do it anyway, right? So you want to do it your own way, and then when you get spanked, how did this happen to me? Because we're in denial, and this message is for us to wake up. Verse 15. Then the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to tend and keep it, verse 16. And the Lord God commanded the man, not asked him, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat. What does freely mean? As much as you want, okay? You can eat as much as you want. No limits. Do it, you know, gorge yourself on everything, right? Verse 17. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall what? Not eat, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. Okay? Are those instructions clear? What did Adam do? He disregarded these instructions. What do we do in 2015? To our parents, to our bosses, to our friends, sometimes give us instructions. Give us, do this, and don't do this, and we still let it go in one ear and do whatever we want. Okay, we have to understand that there's guidelines for us, but when we cross those guidelines, we are surely going to die. Now, we might not die physically, okay, but can a job die? Can you get fired from a job? Can a relationship die? I forgive you. You strayed on me. You cheated on me. You committed adultery on me, and I forgive you, but if you do it again, that's going to be it. And then they go and do it again. So what happens? That relationship dies in regards to that. So we have boundaries, and we have to learn how to follow those boundaries in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's continue now. God warns us to stay away from evil. Okay? So now, before we get to this, because of Adam not obeying and eating of the fruit of this tree, that's why evil has a right. Evil will be here on this planet. You cannot pray to evil go away. Don't waste your time in those prayers. Our prayers have to be in line with the Word of God. What you can pray is that no evil befalls on me, that no evil befalls on me and my household. But you can't say, take evil away from the world, God. I love the world. It's not going to happen until Jesus comes back for us. Do we understand that? Okay, so now, God warns us to stay away from evil. Psalms 34:13. That's all we need. Keep your tongue from what? From evil. And your lips from speaking deceit. 14. Let's go floor with me. Depart from evil and do good. Seek, inquire for, and crave peace and pursue. Go after it. So he tells us to depart from evil. So if you see evil, what should you do? Depart. You run. It is good, right? So let me ask you this. I just lost the name. What was the club that got burned? Blank. What is it? Somebody happened in Paris. Batalan. Okay. A group. Remember we were speaking about judgment and environment. If there's a group called Death, Savage, this and that, what do you think is going to be there? Nice things happening? Right? So if you're going, now we don't know what they say, but just by the title of the group, and you're a believer, you say, why do I got to be doing there? Shouldn't there be a little discernment on what we're going to do? In that example, the other one was at a restaurant, and anything can happen sitting at a restaurant, but let's say that we have to learn how to discern. Remember that we said at the Barclays Arena, one day is being used for Joseph Prince, and the next day is going to be used for something else. So what type of people do you think would be attracted to that type of a concert? Godly, holy people? So you got to say, you know what? I pray for them, but I'm not going to expose myself to be in that environment, because what good can come out of that environment? It says here, depart from evil, do good, seek, inquire for, and crave peace, pursue, and go after it. Amen? Psalms, some of you are looking at me strange. That's okay. The Holy Spirit will get you. Psalms 37, verse 27. Let's all read. Ready to go. Again, depart from evil and do good, and you will dwell forever securely. So we got to learn that place. Don't judge that place. What they're doing, God gives them the right to do whatever they want. But say, I'm not going to partake. I'm not going to expose myself, because I'm putting myself potentially in harm's way. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? Amen. Okay, verse 28, go. For the Lord delights in justice and forsakes not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the offspring of the wicked in time shall be cut off. So now, the Bible is saying to us, do not boast in evil. Psalms 52, verse 1. That's all we need. Why boast you of mischief done against the loving kindness of God and the godly? O mighty sinful man, day after day. Verse 2. Your tongue devises wickedness. It is like a sharp razor working deceitfully. Verse 3. You love evil more than good, and lying rather than to speak righteousness, justice, and right. Selah. Pause and calmly think of that. It's saying for us to pause right here, that love evil more than good. We have to understand, man, that we have to learn how to distinguish the tree of knowledge between good and evil. Sometimes, as I'm ministering now, and I know I messed up as a father, as a parent, in giving certain guidelines to my children here. But once I know, now my job is to relay that guidance to you. So we have believers, and we're letting our kids do whatever they want. I can't control them. They can do whatever. And they go into certain places that are not good for them. And if they get bitten, it's not good. It's our fault, because all we can do is say, don't go here, but don't bless those places. Oh, their friends are going there. It's okay. No, because evil is lurking to take us out. And we have to understand that, that we have to be on guard, discerning where we expose ourselves to in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Verse 4. You love all destroying and devouring words, O deceitful tongue. Verse 5. God will likewise break you down and destroy you forever. He will lay hold of you and pluck you out of your tent and uproot you from the land of the living. Selah, pause and calmly think of that. So now, as we teach here at Hudson Church, we have to live today, this Sunday, as if it was what? The last Sunday. Don't think Monday I'm going to do this. This next week, yeah, we have to plan for those things, but we have to not take for granted today. Those people, did they think that something bad was going to happen to them? Let's go to a restaurant. Everything's going to be good. We're going to enjoy ourselves. Let's go to the concert, or let's just go to the soccer game. We have to understand that we have to be prepared to meet our Maker when? Always. Right now. Don't think tomorrow. That's why we have something against someone. If you need to repent, if you need to ask for forgiveness, don't wait till tomorrow. Stop holding those grudges, because you do not know if this second is going to be the end of it. We have to be alert. We have to be on our guard by faith in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Don't let your mind think, I'm going to wake up tomorrow. Because some of us are not going to wake up tomorrow on that. But let's continue. God will protect us from evil, but evil will still be all around us. So as we said in that club, 129 got killed. Yes or no? But probably, they said that place held like 1,500. So I don't know if that's the final number. But 1,000 got out. Okay? So you have blood on you. You saw people dying. You were exposed. 350 were wounded all around you. So there's going to be. Now, how would you like to have been in that carnage? Okay, so all around you, all mayhem, and that's what we're going to see, Psalms 91, verse 5. Hopefully this will give you more vision. Ready? Let's go. You shall not be afraid of the terror of the night, nor of the arrow, the evil plots and slanders of the wicked that flies by day. Six. Nor of the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor of the destruction and sudden death that surprised and laid waste at noonday. Verse 7. 1,000 may fall at your side, and then 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. But is there going to be death all around us?
Yes.
I mean, those things are going to happen. I'm not here to scare anyone. I'm here to teach you what the gospel is saying to prepare us so that we can be ready. As soldiers, we have to be ready 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Amen?
Amen.
Verse 8, go ahead. Only a spectator shall you be, yourself inaccessible in the secret place of the Most High, as you witness the reward of the wicked. Verse 9. Because you have made the Lord your refuge and the Most High your dwelling place. Verse 10. There shall no evil befall you, nor any plague or calamity come near your tent. So it says come near your tent. Okay, in your house, your tent. What's our tent? You know what our tent? Our bodies. Okay? But there's going to be other people's tents that are going to be wiped out around us. And that's why it's so important for us to preach, to learn about the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ, so that more and more people come into the light instead of living out there in the darkness. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Verse 11. For he will give his angels a special charge over you to what? Accompany and do what? And defend and do what? And preserve you in all your ways of what? Obedience and service. So the angels are going to protect me as I go rob a bank? No. What's the angel going to protect me? As I'm doing obedience to the word of God and in the service of God. Yes or no? So we have to have discernment on where I'm going to expose myself, what I'm going to do, and think a little bit before we do our things. Amen? Verse 12. They shall bear you up on their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. So God has promised us to protect us from evil, all evil. Psalms 121, verse 7. Psalms 121, verse 7. Ready, go. The Lord will keep you from what? From all evil. He will keep your life. Verse 8. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. You're going to believe this or you're not going to believe it. But we have to have wisdom in where I'm going into and where I'm coming out of. Amen?
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 Amen.
So either we believe this or we don't. So now, God says to us another thing. Do not fear evil. Do not fear evil. Psalms 23, verse 4. Ready, go. Yes, though I walk through the deep, sunless valley of the shadow of death, I will fear or dread no evil. For you are with me, your rod to protect and your staff to guide, they comfort me. So let's say you're in an environment and some evil breaks out. What are you to just scream? What do we have to do at that moment? Pray. We better learn how to pray. And a lot of times when things happen, that's the last thing that we do is pray. We scream, we complain, we do a lot of other things. Instead of praying, we have to learn in those moments, and we have to learn this by practice and by us refreshing your mind that when evil comes, pray for those situations. Pray for your angels to deliver you in Jesus' name. We have angels, folks, and we have to command those angels to protect us. Not automatic. We have to command those angels, but by the same token, because I command my angels to protect me, my vehicles, my family, my businesses, my properties, my investments. I command those angels to protect all of those every day in the morning. Now, if I make a poor investment, now I have to be led by the Spirit in my investments, not do whatever I want to do. I have to pray to God. I have to run my plans over God. They can't be my plans. They got to be God's plans for my life in Jesus' name. Amen? If I break my car, I protect my God protect my vehicle. Now I'm going 90 miles an hour on the turnpike. I can do this because my angels are protecting me in Jesus' name. No, I got to still follow my, you know, the speed limit. I still got to have my wisdom, because one thing does not overcompensate for the other. We have to have wisdom in the spiritual and wisdom in the natural, in Jesus' name. Amen.